Hello children, I hope you all are in good health. Yesterday we started the chapter 2, human migration, and we talked about the word migration. Migration is the movement of people from one place to another with the intention of settling, and it can be permanent, it can be temporary also. Now, migration can be in a limited area. For example, one person can migrate from village to cities or to the capital city of that particular state. The migration can be between states, in between states, from one state to another state, and it can be in between the countries. A person can migrate from one country to another country. When a person is migrating from one country to another country, at that time, the migration can be categorized, the people can be categorized as immigrants or emigrants. Immigrants, immigrants. So, immigrants, as it starts from I, आप इसको आय से इन याद रख सकते हैं. इन मतलब अंदर आना. तो इमिग्रेंट्स आर दोज पीपल हु आर कमिंग टू आर कंट्री. एंड एमिग्रेंट्स, EMIGRANT, ई स्टैंड्स फॉर एग्जिट. दोज पीपल हु आर लीविंग आर कंट्री एंड मूविंग टू अनदर कंट्री, दे आर कैटेगराइज एज immigrants. So when a person is migrating from one country to another country, that person is both immigrant in one country and emigrant in another country. Now, last time we also talked about the migration in olden times. Today we will learn about the different types of migration. For that, let's move to your book now. So migration can be of two types, voluntary migration or forced migration. As the name indicates, voluntary means the by own choice or by own wish. So voluntary migration is when people move to another place on their own wish or choice. It may be for better job, better educational opportunities due to marriage, or it can be a transferred case due to one's occupation. We have this short story of senior citizen Anand couple who used to live in Patiala, and they had a son named Hiten. Hiten was transferred to Bangalore. So Hiten and his family used to miss the company of their parents, whereas Anand couple used to miss living with their grandchildren. And the grandchildren, they were also upset as they had this habit of having their grandparents at their home when they come back from the school. So Anand couple happily migrated to Bangalore so that they can live with their children and their grandchildren. This is also a case of voluntary migration. Now, look at the picture. This picture is of Shankar and his friends. They work as labor during sowing and harvesting season. They used to migrate during specific season for employment, and this is known as seasonal employment. Do you know that 7% of the India's population is nomads? Nomads are member of tribe who move from place to place with their animals in search of food, water and grazing ground for their animal herds. Now have a look of this picture. This picture shows nomads of Jammu and Kashmir, and they are known as Gujjars. This image is from Pune and it shows Dhangars of Maharashtra. This must be a common sight for you all, as it shows Gaddis of Himachal Pradesh. And this image shows a member of Raikas tribe of the largest state of India, that is Rajasthan. Raikas stays at their village during monsoon only. So these was few nomad tribes from the different states of India. This was all about the voluntary migration. Just keep one thing in your mind when you are traveling from one place to another during your vacation for the purpose of entertainment, for the purpose of refreshment or for change. That is traveling only. That is not migration. And next is forced migration. Tomorrow we will learn about the forced migration and different types of forced migration. Till then, stay home. Stay safe, stay strong. Bye-bye. Take care.